New skate skiers are often surprised at how hard it can be to make a skate ski work. When you watch an expert, it looks effortless. I remember feeling completely mystified when I was getting started. I thought it would be more like ice skating or skating on my downhill skis, but those skills didn't seem to transfer. At least part of the mystery is explained by the construction and mechanics of the equipment, which is the topic of this video. If you're struggling with skate skiing and you want some practical drills and lessons, check out our membership site, NordicSkiLab.com. We have step-by-step instructional videos, and we've helped many people learn how to skate ski. A skate ski is cambered, which means it's arched up in the middle. The ski is thicker under the binding, then tapers towards the tip and tail. There's a type of vehicle suspension system called a leaf spring. A skate ski is something like a leaf spring. It's designed to wind up and then deliver energy back to the skier during the rebound. The ski contacts the ground near the tip and near the tail. Even when you stand on it and the ski flattens, the strongest points of contact are still at the front and the back of the ski, not underfoot. This reduces friction and helps the ski glide faster, but it also makes the ski more complicated to work. Finally, a skate boot is more supportive than a classic boot, but less stiff than a hockey or figure skate. Plus, the binding attaches at the front of the boot and the heel is not locked down. There are three things we can predict from the design of the equipment. Number one, balance will be challenging. Your center of mass is higher and the equipment does not anchor you firmly to the ground. It will be hard to get your footing at first. Number two, edging the ski can be difficult. You have to deliver some downward pressure to flatten the ski and get the inside edge into the snow because the inside edge is what you push against to move forward. It's easier to edge and push an ice skate because the ground contact is directly under the foot and you have a more stable connection with the ground. You'll need to learn how to manipulate your body position over the skis and work your legs in a way that delivers just the right pressure along the inner edge of the ski to make it work properly. This is quite a complex skill, and you have to learn how to do it on a variety of slopes and in all kinds of snow conditions. The third prediction we can make based on the equipment is that unloading the foot at the end of the skate push can be tricky. You probably know that skate skiing requires a sideways or lateral push. Most people can manage pushing sideways, but it's the final unloading of the foot that often causes problems. The usual way we unload the foot is to roll forward through the ball of the foot and toe off. That's what we do in walking and running. But remember this contact area at the front of the ski. If you roll through the front of the foot in your normal walking way, too much pressure goes into that part of the ski and the tip will nosedive into the snow. The ski won't work properly and you might even trip over it. When I'm coaching, I call this walking feet. Don't underestimate how hard it can be to overcome this habit. You've been training this movement pattern most of your life. This is an exaggerated example, but if you have any remnant of that toeing off movement, it can cause trouble because a small movement in the foot is amplified by the time it gets to the front of the ski. You might try imagining that you're kicking a ball at the end of the push-off. That can help you overcome the habit of rolling forward through the toes. If you're struggling to learn how to skate ski, I want you to know that you are not uniquely uncoordinated or alone in your struggles. The way skate skiing equipment works is quite unusual, and it takes most people a while to get the knack of it. Skate skiing is a lot of fun and great exercise, so don't give up. If you like learning from videos like this, consider joining Nordic Ski Lab. A membership is very affordable, and our videos can save you a lot of time and frustration. We can help beginners start right, and more experienced skiers take their technique up a notch. Check us out at NordicSkiLab.com.